Yes, actually, I'll give you two examples. One was when I was deputy director at the Glenn Research Center. I chaired many of the center level boards and councils. Excuse me. One in particular was the Workforce Council. And prior to me in that role, each major organization directors actually did their own workforce planning strategy, and each hire or recruit had to go before this council. But when I took over, I created a strategic approach where we just looked at it annually, set up the plan, what each organization needed to hire, how we wanted them to hire as far as diversity, as far as a younger type workforce for the future. And then the organizations could go off and execute as long as they stay within those lines. Of course, occasionally you have special cases that come up, then those will come before that council. So that really mitigated lots of meetings by the council. And I'm also a huge proponent of delegating down to the appropriate levels and not getting in the way. So you set up the structure, set up the strategy, and allow people to execute within their domain. That worked out great. We met all of our metrics, actually exceeded, and we had a lot fewer meetings at the council level, and they were long and grueling, so fewer is better. That's one example. Another is when I took over James Webb in early 2018, of course, unlike most programs in NASA, Webb was a single, or is a single program project. Most programs have a portfolio of projects at different life cycle phases. So they're managing across and down and in on some. In the case of Webb, there's a lot of down and in, less across, and a lot of upward leaderships. And both are just as important. I think upward may be more difficult, if believe it or not. So one of the things is, what's the least amount of information that I need to do my job and the least amount of times I need it? Some people believe you need a lot of data, a lot of information, and you set up all kinds of metrics and spreadsheets. Need to determine what's really important, and that's all you ask for. Again, unlike a more traditional program where you have a huge portfolio, another thing is to try not to be the project manager. Because oftentimes at the program level, you're trying to help the project manager manage. I really try to stay out of that space. It gets a little tricky at times. But what data do I need to be efficient and the least amount? What meetings do I need to participate in the least amount? And I consider that fairly efficient without a lot of burden from me to the project manager. Most times we want to be the boss, right? I think that's whatever that word means to you, I think gets in the way sometimes. Oftentimes we want to tell people what to do and how to do it and when to do it. And I don't believe that's the way you manage. I think you set up the structure, roles, responsibilities, accountabilities, the strategy, timeframes for information flow. And then you manage that way. And I also believe in setting up the appropriate environment for people to be successful and get out of the way for them. So that's what I've always believed. I think I've gotten better at it. It's debated at times. But I think wanting to be the boss oftentimes gets in the way and control people and or the situation. I think at a certain point in your career, certainly the type levels we're talking about, you should be experienced enough and confident enough in yourself that you don't need to be in control. Jeez, that's a tough question. I like to think I was born with it. But I've learned with more experience that I think I was born with some, but a lot of it was also taught and learned. So many years ago, at Goddard, some guy running the APPEL program used to tell me that soft skills were very important. Of course, being a technical guy and knew everything, I didn't think it was. So we debated all the time. So I did take a couple of those training modules back then out at Wallops, and I was hooked from the beginning. And I've been preaching the importance of soft skills for a long time. So when I have opportunities, certainly over the years, I've taken many training modules working on soft skills, on leading, on teaming and partnering, managing up, managing down, those types of things. And they've really benefited. So with my innate skills, plus those trained and learned skills, with some mentoring from others, oftentimes after the fact, I call it the coaching moment. Greg, as you should have said it a different way, or next time think about it this way. So over time, you kind of balance all of those skills, regardless of where they came from, whether they're innate, learned in a class, or mentored. One major piece of feedback is you're no longer the project manager once you decide to go into program management. And that's not always easy because you've always kind of controlled things in a good way. That's not a negative in this case. So you have to step away and say, what information do I used to get when I was project manager? Did I really use it? How was it helpful? And what would someone else really want to know above this level? And I think you should manage downward that same way. The other piece is to, just as you managed upward as a project manager, whether you're at a center or I guess most of it is at centers, and you manage up to the center director, just think about that as you're managing up through headquarters and outward, again, to external stakeholders. So more often than not, going up, further towards the top. This is not always the case, and it's certainly not broadly always the case. You have people in the chain who really don't know project management, significant mission development, like a project manager or someone who grew up in that area as a system engineer or something like that. So some of it is giving them the right amount of information without causing them to get too excited in a negative way. And bringing you more help than you really need. You should provide the right information going up. You should not hide information, but also you don't want to create extra work for yourself. So, and that's a delicate thing. Another thing is at the project level and program level, you manage risk a certain way. And it's okay for things to slide a little bit in a good way, schedule-wise. And you don't always have the answer today because you're working, the technical team is working through a solution on a risk. Many times managing up with people want to know the answer this afternoon, and it's not coming for another month or two or three, or at the appropriate time in the life cycle. So you have to find ways to manage through that. And one of the best ways is with, I would say, multiple mentors. I don't always call these people mentors, but talk to people who have experience, who've been through it and done it, and certainly some who have been burned a little bit. They get educated really fast on how not to do it again. So those are the main things. Manage up that way and don't try to be the project manager looking the other direction.